Robotic total station, how to use it. Today, guys, I'm gonna start showing you the Leica TS16 instrument, the great Captivate software here, now coming more and more on the sites here in UK. So if you are into construction, you graduate, or maybe junior engineer, site engineer, and you want to learn more about surveying equipment and how we site engineers work, that's the right place for you. And let's go check that TS16 EDM. This is how our lovely TS16 EDM is looking like. And this is actually station itself. You're gonna be using controller with the same software on it with Leica Captivate. It's gonna be similar to this one, but obviously it's a different one. It's gonna be CS20 like this one here. And what I got here, I got that nice carousel with the jobs, with the options here. So as you can see, we can choose design data. We can open here a new job and we got a default job ready here. But today I'm going to go through the settings and I'm going to show you what we're going to have here. And we're going to actually set few things for ourselves. And I'm going to go from number 7, Leica Captivate. That's the information about our total station here, TS16 1R1000. I wish I had one of these. It's a range 1000, so that's going to be the best one and the most expensive as well. But it's nothing important really here. I'm going to jump quickly to tools. It's not going to be much for us in this case. We got Leica Exchange. We're not going to be using this. We got data transfer. We got calculator. So I don't want you to use a calculator here. Obviously, you can, but if you see my video 10 must have things for every site engineer, for setting out engineer, I want you to have a calculator all the time with you in your pocket. You got format memory, so if you need to format maybe your even SD card or something, you can do it from here. And we got low license keys, so that's going to be for applications. The Leica offers variety of application, but to be honest, we might be using on site 20% of possibilities of these very good instruments, and I sometimes wonder why they use TS16 on site. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. We need to know how to use them now, and we need to know the interface as we need to be up to date. So nothing really special here. Transfer user objects, so you can actually take all the information you got in your instrument by transferring all the objects. As you can see, you're going to be transferring jobs. Obviously, you're going to be transferring jobs as well. Maybe you're going to be sending your EDM on a yearly calibration check or something like that. So you want to keep your job with you. And I'm going to go back, and number 5 going to be system. Not too much really for us as well. We've got heuristic access regional, but screen and audio text input, so we can change here actually audio, sounds and voices, if you want an EDM to tell you points stored and all the stuff. And we got a screen here, so both faces. Mostly we're going to have one face on the EDM anyway, but there's EDMs with the two faces as well, so you can actually take a screen on one face only, especially if you want to save a battery. Remember, this EDM's just draining the batteries very quickly. And I got a software startup, and here we're setting up our startup. So wherever we're going to be turning our instrument on, we're going to get that window. So I actually want the level a total station instrument when we're going to see that nice bubble here, and we're going to be leveling the instrument and enter current temperature and pressure. And I actually press this in, guys, as nowadays you just open your mobile phone and you got pressure, temperature, everything. So it's not taking much time to input it. Although I myself never change it really, but we can do it now very quickly. So it's not a big problem, but working now within maximum few hundred meters, it's not going to be big change. And I got number 4 customization here. So you got up visibility here, nothing really to change. Coding as well, not yet for us. And hotkeys and favorites, I just jump quickly here. As this, you're going to be, as I said, using CS20 controller, and you might actually use some of these to make your life easy, really. And that's going to come when you're going to be using your EDM, so you can set F8, F9, maybe for looking for the prism, maybe turn on the laser, turn off the laser. This is actually for you when you're going to be working and what options you're going to be using the most. I got ID templates here. So what I don't like when I'm surveying my points and I'm saving my points, I don't like this TS0001, 0002, as when I'm opening the survey later on the AutoCAD, I cannot see this. So what I do here, I can change this actually, and I can even set a new one here. And I put it as a P1 here, that's going to be 0.1, only numerically, yes, increment by 1. So that's all I'll need. That's my 0.1. Whenever I'm going to be measuring, it's going to be 0.2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. So I'm going to press OK. I got it now on, and I'm going to press OK again, 0.1. Obviously, you can change the auto point lines, areas as well, but that's what I'm saying. When you're going to be working, you're going to know yourself what you need. And the next one is number 2, user-defined pages. And here we can actually change that page we're looking for. I often change myself here. I want the first lines to be easting, northing, and the height. But it depends on you. Maybe you just got used to just scrolling down and seeing easting, northing. But we engineers should have the most important information first. And for me, this is the easting, northing, and height. And then later distance, slope distance, and all the rest. So I'm going to go back here. You can change it here. I'm not going to be doing it now. Working style wizard, nothing really special here for us. And I'm going to go back to the main menu as a few more things. A point storage. This is only maybe here prompt before storing. So I never turn it on as this actually prompting you before every single point. So I don't like it really, especially when I'm serving point after point after point. And number one is a duplicate point. So when you're going to be serving the same point, or by any chance you're going to have the same name on the point, but you're going to be measuring somewhere else, you can actually get your EDM to prompt you with a warning message, for instance, if it's going to be out of tolerance. You can obviously change these limits here. So then you're going to find out that something is wrong. It didn't change the point ID or something like that. Or maybe you're going to be actually re-measuring the same point. So you can set your EDM here to get the average from these points. Or actually, as I said, to get you that warning message that this is out of your tolerances, which you can set in the same number one here. So I'm going to go back again to the main menu. So number two is total station instrument here. So we got check and adjust. In here, we can actually adjust our instrument. We got the target around 100 meters, so at least 100 meters of our cells. The instrument going to adjust itself, so you can use this option here. I cannot go for it now, I think, but that's when you're going to be adjusting your instrument. We got the cameras here, very useful when we got some targets. We want to leave the crosshair there and make a photo of our new control stations, for instance. So that's a very good thing as well. We can do that some settings here. I'm not going to be going through every single of this. We got the lights here, so we can turn our laser on and off, use the guide lights as well, but I typically turn on the laser from my keyboard. We got the level and compensation here. So, that's exactly what we want to see, 0 and 0. So that's perfect. And you want to make sure always you're going to have a tilt compensator and HZ correction on. And that's going to be actually the screen I set just before to pop up whenever we're going to be starting our instrument. Another window I set to pop up when we're going to be starting the instrument, that's the atmospheric corrections here. And as you can see, we can set the temperature here, pressure and humidity. And as I said before, it's just opening your mobile phone and setting this is maybe only 1 minute. So we got target search here. You can set here the predicting target location and all this stuff. It's no point to changing anything here. We can leave it by default. We're going to be all right. And I got measure and target here. So any surface manually once we can set up here as well. But what I'm going to do, I don't really want to hold you too long here. And all this I'm going to be actually accessing from top here, as there's the options here to access. But that I'm going to show you in the next video. And that will be all for today. And I hope you enjoyed it. It's just the beginning here for Leica TS16. So if you are interested in learning more about Leica TS16, more about this great robotic instrument, just leave the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. As I said, going to be more and more. And leave some comments if you got any questions.